Start spreading the ooze. Yeah, baby, we're in New Yuck, New Yuck at Threat Life Stadium. The fans here can always expect high rent, high Broadway ticket prices, and high body counts, along with the smell of urine in the streets. Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Tokyo Terminators take on the New Yuck Tyrants. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to another game day here on the MFL Network. Grim Blitzrow along with my partner, Brickhead Mulligan.
How you doing?
Great city, isn't it, Bricks?
Fantastic city. My motel even has free color TV.
Oh, that's nice.
An ice machine that works.
Wow.
There was police tape blocking the bathroom because of the photographers in there, but other than that, no complaints. They give you free jelly at breakfast, too.
Sounds like a real winner. Picks up 10 on that run. Man, he nearly broke that one. Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow. Murphy Brown!
What?
I mean, first down!
What the hell was that?
I honestly don't know, Grim.
And it's first and 10. The defender says, that, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and 10. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Does the QB know which team he's on? Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. First and 10. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open. Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. And that'll bring up second and 1. Third down and 3. Oh,
greatest tits? Where?
And it's first and 10. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the deep. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. Scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
And it's first and 10. Sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger because he's gonna kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message because the messenger killed him. I'm going in circles.
And that'll be second down and 4. And the defense calls a Strawberry Fields dirty trick. Now this takes me back to those crickets. You've got to catch that. Third and 4. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
It's first and 10. The defense called a one-speed dirty trick. Man, looking like Rex's bowels. He is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Oh, look at this guy break tackles. He takes a licking and keeps on ticking. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The running plays. And it's first and 10. Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. And they run it for a couple of yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go. And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
And it's first and 10. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have... Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
And it's first and 10.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and 10. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division and weep tonight.
It helped.
Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. And the...
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy...
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And so at the end of one, we're all tied up. We'll be right back. And it's first and 10. And he held on to that one for a first down. It's first and 10. Second down and long.
He should give this guy a bigger pick.
He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Wim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And it's It's first and 10. And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10. Meets the explodable object. The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And it's first and 10. Come on, man, you gotta catch that.
I don't catch anything, Grim. I'm retired.
Second down and 10. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Third down and 10. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot into that one. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. First down and 6. And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender right now. Does the QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know where I'm at.
Oh, with the brutal hit. And the ref just called a bullshit penalty. First down and 3. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. First down and 1. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Man, look at him dance. He can't help himself. Looks like someone needs to watch Blade Runner again. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then? Run.
Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's 1st and 10. He is rolling thunder and... Oh, and the defender knocked the ball out when he was in midair. It is a fumble indeed.
Fumblemanji, the new game from Wilton Crabtree.
First down and one. The defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. And that'll bring up second and one. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
The brain scrambler. And it's first and ten. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. The offense has no running backs left, so they will lose all running plays in their playbook. Third down and six. Sleeties this morning. Oh, nice hit. And it's first and ten. He's off to the races. He's at the 30. And he put the jets on and caught him from behind. And it's first and 10. And that takes us to the 2-minute warning. It's first and ten. Five-yard gain on that pass play.
Hey, look at the coach. He's picking his nose. You know, they shouldn't put that on the...
And they take their first timeout.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
Second down and five. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
Plays on defense, schmuck.
Third down and five. And that's another turnover for the defense.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
It's first and ten. His cleats are... He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. He's at the 40. Great shoestring tackle. and it's first and 10. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, see, that Brett's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it.
Nice pickup for 6 yards.
I know why they said never hit a man when he's down. It's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Rim? That would make more sense.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And he just wrestles away from that tack. Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show, sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Roundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. The third quarter is about to begin, and if it's as much of a blowout as the first half was, we may see a riot in the stands.
Well, that's going to happen either way, Grim. It's a $1 Red Bull crap and vodka jello shot day.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
QB is saying his prayers. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
No return on this punt. The defense will just down it.
I can't tell if he's smart or scared. Either way, the ball's down.
And it's first and 10. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. Hey, Bricks, check the rule book. Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
And this is a first and long. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. I hope you covered your ears, Bricks, because that was a sudden. And like Bricks' bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
And it's first and 10. And I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. You just. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10. Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. Second down and 10. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And it's first and 10. He's supercharged and can electrocute any of...
another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined, you'd expect him not to play like total shit.
No arguments from me, partner.
Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
Yeah.
And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and ten. A good heads-up play there, getting it out of bounds. Better than throwing a pick. Second down and 10. That pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick your head in a plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards when you set yourself on fire and jump out the window. It ought to stop.
Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. First and 10. He could go all the way.
He scores.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Second down and 10. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
Nice punt. Should move him back nicely. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. And the defense just knocked the wind out of that quarterback.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Second down in a mile. Oh, the strawberry feels dirty trick. As my mentor Hunter used to say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol, narcotics. And that's the way you do it. Eat up chunks of yards with pinpoint passing. Third down and 6. And the quarterback finds his man for the first.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. First and four. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's first and ten.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten. And this guy is supercharged with electricity. And he just slipped away like a greased pig. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Oh man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. Third down and the offense needs a miracle. Totally uncalled for, and that's why we love the MFL. The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over.
I got the thing stuck in my ear again.
But crazy works in the MFL sometimes. Other times, it just comes back with a shotgun. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And he was stuck to him like glue. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. This guy's a brick shit. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
Nicely done for a first down. Oh, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Oh, great throw! Great catch! And then put 6 points. You gotta be fucking kidding me. If that's a penalty, they should come up here and penalize us, too.
Hey, don't give these refs any ideas.
offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery.
I hope that bribe covered funeral expenses. The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And he's off to the races. Third and two. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah, he'd probably have it intercepted, though.
He broke free and has open field in front of him. And it's first and ten. For a first down. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico for rather to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but they're not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second down and 10. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo grip.
Oh, come on. That was a cheap. The New York Tyrants bash the opposition into nothingness and walk away with a win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now and we go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say?
Today's game was brought to you by Comcrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.